Hi, this is Tony Batt for Gambling Compliance in Washington, D.C. We're in the Capitol Hill office of Congressman McDermott, who is offering legislation that would tax internet gambling. And you also may be the first congressman I know of who's a knight. Isn't it true that in 2007 you were knighted by the King of Lesotho?
It's true, I did. But so, not for gambling. It's for other issues.
The Growth and Improvement Act of Africa.
Exactly. I was the sponsor of the Trade Development Program for Africa called African Growth and Opportunity Act.
Well, we're here to talk today, though. I guess I should refer to you as sir, in any case.
My name is Jim.
Okay, Jim. Let me talk about the Internet Gambling Act, because, of course, Congressman Frank has introduced a bill to repeal the Unlawful Internet Gambling Enforcement Act of 2006. As a companion bill, you have introduced legislation which would serve as a funding mechanism for the Frank bill and raise about $42 billion over a 10-year period by taxing internet gambling. We had a hearing yesterday in the House Financial Services Committee, and I'm sure you've been briefed on that. What do you think about what happened in the hearing in House Financial Services Committee, and where do you see this legislation going now?
Well, this, I think, was the fifth hearing, and my view is that people are gradually coming to grips with the issue that you have a situation where people gamble. I mean, anybody who says you can stop gambling is simply got their head buried in the sand and is paying no attention. We tried that in this country once before. We said, let's ban drinking. So we're gonna stop, we'll have prohibition. That didn't work. And this business about saying we're not going to have gambling legal is not going to work. People are gambling under the table. They're going to Antigua. They're going all over the place. And it makes no sense at all. And I've always contended that you ought to bring it back and make it legal and then tax it. And I haven't found very many gamblers who aren't willing to accept that bargain. If we get it legal, then we accept the taxes. And I think that that's... the committee is gradually coming to understand that that makes sense. There's a certain resistance in people always to gambling. Gambling's awful. Except that then they go make a bet on a horse race, or they go make a bet on a football team, and that's okay. It's always sort of what somebody else is doing is bad. And so you have to get the committee to kind of realize that there are millions of people out there who like to play poker and would like to play it online, and it doesn't make sense to say this is the one place you can't do it. I went on Sunday to the racetracks, and I'm standing there putting my $2 down on a horse, which I probably lost, but that was legal. Why is it I can't sit and play poker online with you? What's the difference? Where's the moral problem that's created? I just don't see it, frankly.
What about this rumor going around that the House Financial Services Committee may vote as early as next week on the Frank bill?
There's a real good chance. We're rounding up the votes one at a time. And it's a matter of talking to people and getting them to commit. And there are, you know, politics is complicated. There are people who really are opposed to gambling and think you can stop it if you just make a tough enough law. Well, we've proven before that doesn't work. But we're counting the votes one at a time, going to each member, talking to them about it, find out what their problem is. Actually, the money that we're going to use, that we're going to raise, the $40 billion, is going to be used for children's programs. I mean, I've laid out for child nutrition, and for children who are foster kids, giving them some kind of a decent start into their adult life. And there are a number of places, early child education that the president wants. So there are a lot of things that are there that we can't fund. And here's a ready source of income and people who actually are willing to be taxed. The rule around here always is, don't tax you, don't tax me, tax that guy behind the tree. We're always looking for a guy behind the tree. Well, in this case, we got gamblers who are saying, hey, look, let us do it legally. We'd be glad to pay a tax.
So are you confident that by the end of this year, Congress will pass the Frank bill and your bill, which goes right along with it?
Well, I'm a physician, and I know from my practice as a doctor that one should never say never. I think it's very, very likely that this bill will pass. I wouldn't say 100% it's going to pass, but I would say it is very likely. First of all, because we need the money, and we need the money for programs that people basically support. I haven't found anybody who resists paying for children's services out of this money. So that's why I think we've got a winning combination. And I, that's my hand, and I'm holding it. Let's see.
Tell us about the money in your bill. Now, you say $42 billion over 10 years. There are other groups who say it could go up to as high as $72 billion over 10 years because of this 6% deposit amendment that you added to your legislation. Can you explain that?
Well, what we did was we put a tax on at the federal level. So at the federal level, we get $42 billion. Then there's an additional option for states that want to. We're not forcing them, but if they would like to, they can impose a tax that would raise another estimated $30 billion at the state level. So in our, we've got states in this country who are in terrible problems, who would grab that in an instant to put it on so that they could fund some of what they're now cutting. I mean, I've been hearing stories from my own state about what's happening to children's services with respect to abused kids. And they're cutting school teachers, and they're cutting firemen, and they're cutting policemen. And they're looking for a source of money, and here is a source that is only waiting to be taken. And that's why I think my hand is a pretty strong hand.
Finally, if your legislation does not pass this year, what will be your plans in 2011 regarding this issue?
Well, I personally feel we're not going to be out of it economically, all the problems we're in. We're going to be right back in 2011 looking for money. And I'm just going to come back and say, listen, stop talking to me. I sit on the Ways and Means Committee. We raise the taxes in this country, and we allocate what gets spent. And don't talk to me about anything you want if you won't vote for this. I mean, that's going to be my position in 2011 if we don't get it done. I think we're going to get it done in 2010.
This is Congressman McDermott. He represents most of Seattle in your district and is running for a 12th term this year and is expected to be reelected. Is there anything you could add?
No, I think that this is one of those unusual situations where we actually have a constituency that is willing to be taxed. I've done politics for a long time, and I've never seen one like this before. This makes this unusual.
Congressman, thank you for your time.
My pleasure.